Friends of Goulburn High and the 108th Goulburn High School presentation ceremony. Please stand at the entry of the official lobby.
Yuma Lundi, Hallowent welcomes staff and students to this very special award ceremony for 2020 that is being held on traditional Aboriginal land. It is a privilege to stand on country and walk in the footsteps of those before us. Underneath the plastic, metal and wood that you are seated upon today, along the riverbeds and amongst the gum trees, is land that has a rich cultural significance. We acknowledge the traditional custodians of this land who have performed age-old ceremonies of storytelling, music, dance, celebration and renewal. We pay our respects to elders past, present and emerging and acknowledge the strength, knowledge and resilience of Aboriginal people in the Goulburn area and Australia-wide. Thank you and congratulations to all students who have completed another year of schooling.
Please remain standing for the National Anthem. It is my pleasure to introduce the members of the official body for Goulburn High School's 108th presentation ceremony. They are seated in the rows to make that. We have Mr. Manny, Dean O'Connell, head teacher of 10-7, Mr. T, your advisor, and Ms. Wines. I would like to invite Mr. Manny for his principal school report number 20.
Dear parents, carers, students, staff in the broader community, I'm delighted to present the principal's report for 2020. I extend a warm welcome to all as we connect here today through this online platform to celebrate achievements of our talented young men and women. This occasion marks my first prize giving as principal of Goulburn High School, and I'm incredibly proud to represent this great school and celebrate with you the successes of our students here today. Behind every prize and every success are the teachers, parents, carers, family members, friends and supporters who have been with our students every step of the way through the highs and lows. Today we can all sit back and feel very proud of your achievements and who you are becoming as a young person. Your story is still being written. Prize giving is a time for us as educators and learners to reflect on the world and the space of change we are navigating in the way we all approach education. As a school, We must continue to embrace the requirement to change and adapt, to chart new course built from the strengths of what we do best, teaching and learning. Change is a constant in this rapidly evolving world. We recognize the challenge to prepare our students for a world where innovation, collaboration, resilience, and the ability to solve complex problems will be required. A world where key strengths of young person will need are the ability to learn, to be adaptive, relational, and culturally located. At Goulburn High School, we are aspirational. We'll strive to deliver student-centered learning, which is connected, culturally located, authentic, and exciting, where all our students want to be engaged, where our community willingly shares its skills, strengths, and values, and where learning is at the core. This is an aspirational journey. We get what we expect, and our community must continue to expect great things from our school and our young people. Our collective challenge as a school in 2021 is to continue to grow not only strong young men and women who experience academic success, but young people who are compassionate and considerate. We thank all parents, caregivers for your ongoing support of our school and look forward to continuing to build strong working relationship focused on student success next year. We have celebrated the character, the commitment and achievements of our students in academia, sport and arts. Four students will be receiving awards today for academic excellence and other school activities. Congratulations, well deserved. For sports, Goulburn High continues to be well supported and catered for at Goulburn High School by our dedicated and hard-working PDHPE faculty and the whole school. It was particularly impressive this year where our school completed all three sporting carnivals under very challenging circumstances. I want to congratulate students who will be receiving sports award today. As principal, the quality of our staff and the potential we have for making a profound difference in the lives and the learning of students in our care is of paramount importance to me. I feel very blessed to be working with some of the best educators that I have had the privilege to work alongside. Me, the drive, the passion, the determination underpinned by the skill, knowledge and empathy has seen teaching and learning continue to raise progress and achievement despite the ever-changing social, learning, emotional needs that we are confronted with today. The resilience required from the 21st century teacher is an incredible mix of passion, professionalism, patience and persistence. In acknowledging the teaching staff, I acknowledge too the wonderful support team that ensures this school runs smoothly. They're often the unsung heroes of our school. Every member of this staff team, both teaching and non-teaching, is a critical function in the school success of this school. Please know that your contribution and efforts are most valued and appreciated. I must also pay tribute to the supreme dedication and support of my leadership team, Deputy Principals, Ms. Michelle Ryan and Mr. James Vaughan, and the head teachers. I thank you all for your support and guidance this year. Finally, I want to thank our hardworking and dedicated PNC who plays such an active role in education of all students. In particular, I want to thank our President, Mrs. Renee Woodbury, who works tirelessly to support the school in every possible way. As the principal, I'm committed to working collaboratively with our PNC to provide quality education to every student. In closing, I want to wish everyone Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
I would now like to introduce Claire Neal to present the report for the Student
We began the year with a major increase in students electing to represent themselves as part of the SRC. This was so exciting for us as students, as these new members came with new ideas and visions to better our school in great ways. Our first task of the year was having a council with the senior executive to discuss the current school year and change the new members to students' needs. This was an amazing opportunity for members of the SRC to work with the senior executive. and discuss student-based ideas with these staff members. We were also invited to meet with Prefect Lancashire and Mr. May to discuss the new school plan. This was an opportunity for us to give voice from the student body to our principal. On the main meetings, we believe that we will be in our school's future. We are very grateful for these opportunities to work with the senior executive and look forward to continuing this in the coming years. The SSC were also involved in a range of fundraising events for the school and wider community in 2020. These include things like Jeans for Jeans Day and RSPCA Comeback Day. To finish off the year, we are very excited for our school colour. It will be happening tomorrow. It will be so great to finish what has been quite a difficult year with the colour, with a big colourful event. We are looking forward to our 2021 will bring and encourage more students to join our team for next year.
Thank you, Claire. Our SRC does an excellent job representing the students and providing opportunities for leadership. The SRC is responsible for many excellent school programs. I would now like to invite Mr. Manning to present the Year 7 2020 Awards for Excellence and Achievements. The Awards for Excellence and Achievements will be announced by the Year 7 Year Advisor, Ms. Deanna Collins.
Roberts, nursing PDHD. Charlotte Watts, second in PDHD.
Fantastic young students in our school for what you have to go through. It is not normal. We started off the year in our swimming calendar, and it was normal. Fantastic day, fantastic competition, everybody had fun. That's what high school's about, that's what carnivals are about. Yesterday we'll be recognising those students that achieved outstanding results, but I'd like to congratulate everybody that put your hand up and stood up and got themselves to that carnival. That's what Goulburn High School and school's about. I'd like to award in term one our swimming at each champions. I can have Jamie Van Wilson and Tyler Stanley to come forward, please, our AIDS champions. Seemed like in term two, everything started to fall apart. And I spoke about this with our year 12s, and I felt so sorry for them this year with the outstanding athletes that we had in year 12 that could not compete in any sport. Our knockouts were canceled, our team sports were canceled, and we thought we were going to have to, and we did, but unfortunately or fortunately, we have a senior executive and a principal that believe that we could run these carnivals. We decided, well, we can't do it in term two, but if we get the opportunity in term three, we're going to go with it. And we did in cross country in term three, we went. Although our day, we had to come back to school because of the heat and a few different things. We did exactly what we wanted. We wanted to recognize our outstanding runners in cross country, and we got the opportunity to do that. I'd like to now announce Taylor Campbell, 12 years, and Tyson Gray, our two age champions, 12 years. And our 13 years champion, Jack Patel. Lessons, but as soon as term four came around, our executive, we took our case to the executive, said this, we run a school athletics carnival fun day, and they gave us the go ahead. So only a few weeks ago we had our school carnival, and I'll say to people, I've been to many of the carnivals, that was one of the best carnivals that Goulburn High School has had in many, many years, and it was especially because of year seven and how many year sevens in our junior school attended that carnival, and that was fantastic to see. Our age champions on the day were Charlotte Watts, she was a little bit faster than 100 meters if I remember, and Toby Rollins. In over 100 years has been cancelled for a year, and you know, that's unheard of. So you will get the opportunities next year in team sports. Obviously we want you to take up the individual sports as well, Smith Cup and anything else that we do run. My last award is what we call Bowman's premier sporting challenge, and this happened with Miss Chapman Frequilli, and this year's recipient is Casimir Kuehl. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Tidden. Now, we will all be entertained by video performance of year 7 student Mia Octaviano. Thank you. That was a wonderful performance. Now, I would like to give a big thank you to our PNC for their ongoing support to Goulburn High School. Parents and community members are an important part of our school community, providing financial support and contributing to school decision-making and building the links between school and home.
2020 has been an extraordinary year for countless reasons. So many ups and downs, changes in all of our lives, and events in Australia that we hope we will never have to live through again. As the whole country has had to pull together to support each other, so have we here at Goulburn High. Support to our families, our students and our teachers. Thank you to you all for working through 2020 with us. Some things certainly never turned out as we hoped, although from this, some of us found strength we never thought we'd have. Homeschooling was interesting, and I think we all learned a little something from that experience. Another Year 12 has finished. They have absolutely missed so many fun things that happen in Year 12, their rite of passage, but the strength they gained from this being commendable. The most difficult year a Year 12 group could ever imagine. You are all a wonderful, resilient group of students that we will always be proud of, and you should be proud of yourselves. We know this has been difficult for you all. During 2020, the PNC have still worked extremely hard. Melinda in the canteen really is a superstar. I have no reservations in stating we undoubtedly have one of the best canteens, if not the best, in our region, always providing healthy food for all of our students, as well as the tremendous catering efforts and willingness to take on any job requested. The PNC and the canteen now also provide the book pack requirements for the students, countless hours of sorting and trying to get you the best value for your money. Bronwyn in the uniform shop, she has been amazing and has been on board now going into her 6th year. She is an absolutely wonderful asset, supplying our students and families the best possible service and assisting all of our families with their uniform requirements. In 2021, our school will welcome a new group of Year 7 students. The PNC will welcome new faces and with that, new ideas. Recently, we have been proactively working together, investigating with Goulburn High what our students need. Our job has always been to positively assist Goulburn High School achieve new projects so our students can enjoy the best possible facilities they deserve. Lastly, I would like to proudly welcome Mr. Yogesh Meni to the position of principal. Our future is definitely looking bright and encouraging, and we have the utmost confidence that the new partnership between the PNC and Goulburn High School will be a fantastic working relationship. Congratulations, Mr. Meni, and well done to Goulburn High School for the positive progress we have made in such a short time and the future positive plans we hold. On behalf of the PNC, I would like to wish everyone a Merry Christmas and a wonderful holiday, and see you in 2021. Thank you.
The PNC Awards are presented to students who have shown strong commitment to their learning throughout the year. I would like to invite Mr. Teague to present the next award.
Jack Heavenly Father,
Sean Watts, Yeah, okay. currently Waterman Family Rights Family Prize in Science. Dr. Joseph A. Waterman was a Duxford at Goulburn High School in 1946. He had an illustrious career in science, mainly in physics and atmospheric science, where he was responsible for making new discoveries in the advancement of weather modification. He was the author of 150 scientific manuscripts published in scientific journals of Australia, USA, and Europe. The bulk of his career was spent in the world. He was educated at the University of Queensland and the University of Sydney. The recipient of the Waterman Family Prize for Science is Jack Brown. Includes Family Award for Upholding School Values. This award is in memoriam of Jack Lewis, whose entire teaching career was spent at Goulburn High School, and this award goes to Scott Bayless. Thank you, Mr. Teague, and congratulations to the award recipients who have worked so hard to achieve these honours. Goulburn High School SPARS program, standing for the Students Positive Achievements Reward System, allows students to progress through a number of levels by recognising student effort and commitment. A positive behaviour for success program acknowledges the reward students who constantly demonstrate school values of respect, responsibility, and resilience. Tonight we are recognising these students who have continued to demonstrate Goulburn High School values constantly at Goulburn. I would like to invite Mr. Bond to present these students with the Goulburn High School's last certificates. Silver, Xander McDonald. Thank you. the award for Hell of Excellence and Ducks of the Year, so is Chris Daniel Blumenhardt.
I'm going to go to the next thing.